vacation now.
Yeah.
You like it.
Thank you.
this may surprise you, but today I want to point out similarities between myself and both of the nominees at the top of the other ticket. You see, in one way, I'm just like their vice presidential nominee. Neither one of us shares the political views of their presidential nominee.
Stock market crash almost inconsequential.
The Democrats trotted out Jimmy Carter to say, I told you so, end quote. And you know something? When I saw that happen, when the liberals try to tell the American people they won't raise taxes, but fail to mention the new spending programs they've promised every liberal special interest group in Washington, are we going to stand by and let them get away with it? When the liberal leadership tries to portray themselves as the newly ordained champions of law and order,
that the American people take out behind the bar.
The next president may have the opportunity to appoint three and possibly four new justices shortly after taking office. We want to tell the American people what it will mean for their future if it's George Bush making those appointments. And finally, there is this one last issue. Yes, more important than even all the other crucial matters I've discussed with you today. Ladies and gentlemen, when we were together in Detroit in 1980 and Dallas in 1984, I wonder how many of us could really have believed then that so many of our fondest hopes and dreams for America would come true. In every fiber of my being, only electing George Bush President of the United States can accomplish that. So let us go forth this week to tell the American people what's really at stake, the fate of generations to come, the hopes of peace and freedom for our children, for all the children of the world. Don't let anyone tell you this is just another campaign. Don't let anyone tell you that we're just good administrators out to renew our management contract. Instead, remember this. This isn't a campaign, it's a crusade. A crusade for America's future. And this too, we aren't just.
Mr. President, tomorrow morning I will gavel the convention to order, and that will mark the beginning of an exciting 4 days. 7.5 years ago, you gave America a new beginning, and it's only appropriate that we finally give you your gavel.
Gipper gavel.